today I created this super, super easy, super glam makeup look. I actually did no eyeshadow for this. I used my bronzer in my crease area, and then I used my highlighter on the lid. And this look was just so easy. It took me maybe, I'd say like 30 minutes to film it. It really wasn't that much. And if I was doing it without filming it, this would have taken me like 20 minutes, 15 at the least. So this is just like a super, super easy way to glam yourself up if you have to go out somewhere, or if you're just feeling like wearing some lashes and a red lip. This is a great way to get ready super, super quick and super easy. And if you want to see how I got this look, then please keep watching. Hi everyone. So we are just gonna jump right into the skin today for this video. Going in with my NYX Angel Veil Primer. Literally like the best drugstore primer I've ever found. It's my favorite. I'm almost out and I really, really need to get some more. So for foundation, I'm going with my Laura Mercier Candle Glow Soft Luminance Foundation. I've been loving this. I've been using it nonstop. And just to give this a little bit more luminosity to it, I'm going in with this e.l.f. Highlighting pearl paint, and I'm just gonna mix that in with my foundation on the back of my hand. I'm not using too much of it, but I am just using a little bit just to give me that extra glow. And now, as you can see, my skin is super, super glowy. That foundation alone is really glowy to begin with. But just adding a little bit of that liquid highlighter really, really intensifies it. So, for concealer, I'm going in with this LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Porcelain. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply this underneath my eyes. Then I'm going on all the high points of my face. And then, just for a little bit more coverage, I'm taking my Sephora Bright Future Gel Serum Concealer in the shade 7 Custard. And I'm just going to put a little bit of this right below that LA Girl concealer. Just because this one is just a little bit darker. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this around the edges of that first concealer that we used. Just to help everything blend. Then I will go back with that same beauty blender. Just to blend everything out. Sorry if you guys can hear like a creaking sound. I have my ceiling fan on and it's like going crazy right now. Like, it's kind of annoying, but it's whatever. I would much rather be cool and not sweating my makeup off. Now, as you can see, my under eyes are just super, super bright. Both of those concealers are very, very brightening. And the LA Girl concealer is like really full coverage. cream products. I'm going in with my NYX Wonder Stick, which I'm literally almost out of. And I'm in the shade Universal. And I'm just going to apply some of this just right there at my cheekbones. I was going to use my LA Girl concealer in the shade Toast, but I forgot I had a little bit left of this Wonder Stick, so I need to use it while I can. I am going to take this Morphe G6 brush, just a flat buffer brush, and I'm just going to blend this contour in with this. Now that we're done with our cream products, I'm just going to go ahead and blend out my creases. So as you can see, I'm already a creasy mess, as usual. And then I'm just going to take a little bit of my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder. I'm just going to set right underneath the eyes. I'm also going to set the eyelid as well. And then I'm going to take my NYX highlighting and contour palette. As you can see, mine is super beat up and I really need to get another one. But I'm going in with this banana shade right here. And I'm just going to take that and put it underneath the eyes just a little bit, just to tone down how light our under eyes are right now. Usually I like a really bright under eye, but we are going for just easy, pretty glam today. So I'm also going to take that powder and set all the places that I put concealer. And I'm just taking a really big powder brush and I'm just like swirling it around. That banana shade, I'm not picking up too much. And I'm just setting down the rest of my skin really, really lightly. I don't want to take away the luminosity of my skin, but we are going to go on with a few powder products. And I don't want anything to be tacky so that my other products stick to the skin or they don't go on as smoothly as they could. So, to finish off the face, I'm going in with... I'm going in with, to be honest with you, I think I'm just gonna like dab in all of these. I'm mostly gonna take these three shades. I don't really want that one as much, but these three, I think I'm just gonna dabble in all of those. I don't really have a shade that I use in this palette. I just kind of pick one. I'm just going right over where we put that cream contour at. It has been so long since I've used this palette to contour. I forgot that these shades, they're kind of like, I don't want to say orangey. They're not orangey. They're kind of like, they have like a red undertone. And normally I don't like that. Like the, Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer, it kind of has like a red undertone to it. And like I have it and I still use it and everything, but I just prefer bronzers that either have like a really warm tone to warm up the skin or cool tone to contour. I'm not really a big, like, I don't know, red undertone fan. It doesn't look as flattering on me, but it's okay. So once we have that done, I will just go back in with my powder brush and just kind of blend around just to make sure there are no harsh lines,
Everything is nice and blended into my skin.
And now for my blush. We are just going to go ahead and finish the whole face because the eyes are super, super simple. So we're going to go ahead and finish the face. For my blush, of course, I'm going in with this blush. This is the Flower Beauty Flower Pots Blush in the shade Warm Hibiscus. It is like my favorite blush at the moment. It has been for a few months now. It's just the prettiest pink and gold mix. It's just so pretty. I do have to be very light-handed with this, though, because this blush is super, super pigmented. Like, I always just tap in this blush one time, and it just amazes me. Now, as you can see, this is just, like, really continuing with the glowy effect. This just adds the prettiest, like, healthiest glow to the skin. Now for highlight, I'm going in with my Milani Strobe Light Instant Glow Powder in the shade Sun Glow. I have been obsessed with these highlighters lately. I have this one, and then I have a Day Glow, I think, and Day Glow is kind of like a more cool tone, but they are both so pretty, and they're so cheap. I have been using these, like, nonstop. So I'm taking this on a MAC Studio fan brush, and I'm just going to go ahead and begin applying this to the face. Like, do you guys see that? This highlighter was like $9.99 at Walgreens, and guess what? They had buy one, get one 50% off, so that's why I got two, and they're so good. Like, I have never seen a drugstore highlight be this pigmented. And it's not, like, powdery or anything. It's, like, super, super creamy and blendable. So now that we have that on, I'm going to go in as usual and blend with my powder brush. Go through and go ahead and clean up the bottom of my brow. It's not too messy or anything, but I'm not doing too much of the eyeshadow, so I just want to go ahead and get that get underneath my brow bone kind of highlighted so that we don't have to do it later. That done, I'm going to go ahead and highlight my brow bone. I'm going in with this LA Girl Strobing Powder in the shade 110 Watt. It is just a little bit lighter than that first highlighter that we used. I don't want to use the one we used on our face underneath my brows just because it's a little bit too gold and it's a little bit too dark to highlight the brow bone. I'm just gonna go ahead and set my eyebrows into place. So, like I said earlier, the eyes are super, super simple. So, I'm literally just going in with my big fluffy brush. And those shades that we used to contour, or bronze, or whatever. And then I'm just going to run this into the crease. Just add a little bit of definition, not too much.
I have that done. I'm just going to take that Milani highlighter we used on the face. And I'm just going to take it with my finger and just pop this right here on the lid. Then I'm going to take some of this LA Girl highlighter, the one we used on the brows. And I'm just taking this and putting it right in the middle of the lid just to add some dimension. And then I'm going to go in the inner corner. And I wasn't going to put anything on my lower lash line, but just for the heck of it, I am just going to run a little bit of these bronzing shades just on the lower lash line, not too precise or anything, just getting a little bit of color under there. So now for lashes, I'm going in with these Ardell Demi Wispies, the faux mink ones, and I'm just going to go ahead and trim these down a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and apply some lash glue, and while I'm waiting on that to dry, I will just go ahead and throw on some mascara. I'm just going to go ahead and apply my lashes. So now that the lashes are on, I'm going to go ahead and wipe away this powder, and then I'm going to go in with my lip liner. This is the NYX lip liner in the shade Hot Red. I'm just going to line my lips with this. And now I'm going in with the Too Faced Melted Matte Lipstick in the shade Lady Balls. It's like one of my favorite reds. I'm just going to apply this all over the lips. Once that dries, I'm just going to go in and add just a little bit of gloss. It's right in the middle. Okay, everyone. So I just went off camera and just kind of like roughly curled my hair a little bit and just put it up. I cannot tell y'all how happy I am with this makeup. Like, this, I know I say this a lot, but this is like my new favorite. Like, I might start wearing this every day. I just keep looking at myself in the mirror because it looks so good. So if you guys enjoyed this video and you want to see more like this, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Give this video a big old thumbs up. Leave me a nice comment, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.